All right, so here's our homework solutions from Chi Squared Homework 1. You can pause if it goes too fast. Remember, 9 and 5 and 1 are all tied together, 2 and 6 and 10, 3 and 7 and 11, and so forth. So, number 5, here's the breakdown based on each nut. Number 6, here's your proportions, 18 out of 30, your fractions, 18 out of 38, 2 out of 38, and we did 5 and 6 together. Number 7, kind of hinted at that with you, there's 5 different colors, so evenly distributed, so it'll be 46.6. Number 8, 6 colors, so evenly distributed at 20. And then 9 through 12, here are the actual calculations. You can hit pause and we'll move on. All right, new notes. Day 2, chi-squared test for good, for test for goodness of fit. All right, so many of the steps with formal hypothesis testing will stay the same. There are a few changes. All right, so for formal hypothesis tests, define what you are trying to figure out, such as distribution of M&Ms has changed, birthdays are equally distributed, and the level of significance. We're going to write the null and alternative hypotheses, and we can write sentences instead. I'm going to show you that. That's a little bit easier and quicker. So, for example, the distribution of M&M colors hasn't changed. And the ha would be, yeah, the distribution did change. So this is no change. And the ha is change. So number 3, we're going to check conditions. Does it tell us it was randomly done? And then all the expected counts need to be greater than or equal to 5. So basically for that, we're going to look at the table. Now, we may be given the expected values. We may have to calculate the expected values. We've done both ways. Number 4, there's our calculation we've already done on day 1. Number 5, find the p-value, which we've already done, and then draw a picture and shade accordingly. Now, remember, this is always going to be the tail to the right in this area. And degrees of freedom is number of categories minus 1. And then number 6, make a decision. So if P is less than A, alpha, we're going to reject the ho, which means we have convincing evidence for the ha. And if we fail to reject the ho, we do not have convincing evidence. For the ha. Remember, we can find someone on a jury trial guilty or not guilty, we can't find them innocent. Alright, first example. So we're going to look at the M&M one from yesterday. So you're going to flip in your notes to look at that. Define what you're finding and alpha. So number 1. We're trying to decide if the distribution of M&Ms has changed. Okay? And then our alpha is 0.05. It's not stated differently. We always go with 0.05. Then two, our hypothesis, our ho and our ha. So quite simply, ho, like we talked about in the example, M&M distribution, we can abbreviate here, hasn't changed. Has not changed. And then for our ha, M&M distribution has changed. Key number three, check conditions. Well, it was given to us random. So same as always. And then the table. So let's look at the table. I put it here again to refer to. So we have blue, we have brown, we have green, orange, red, yellow, and purple. 28, 21, 19, 29, 55, 39, and 59. And our expected values were 25, 25, 25, 25, 50, 50, 50. Right? So we write down expected greater than or equal to 5, check. We go to the chart. All the expected values are greater than or equal to 5. Now number 4, this is just a simple calculation, it's just tedious. Curvy line, straight line. So we have 28 minus 25 over 25, and of course this is squared, plus 21 minus 25, of course this is squared, over 25, plus 19 minus 25, over 25, and I'm just going to put a dot, 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 because we've already done this, 59 minus 50, squared, over 50. And that gave us 7.62. So this is just taking information from the other day, from yesterday. So for 5, it says find the p-value, draw the picture in shade. So 5, we're going to shade out here, 7.62. And we found the p-value to be, using our calculator, 0.2673. Remember, our degrees of freedom is 6. So again, just use a calculator to calculate that. Number 6, we make our statement. Since my p-value, I can spell, which was 0.2673, is greater than alpha, which is 0.05, we fail to reject the ho. We do not have convincing evidence we do not have convincing evidence Hang on, I'll write letters in there. Let's see. C-I-N-G. Yep. Distribution has changed. That is abbreviated distribution. Okay, hit pause if you need to. We'll move on. Alright, Josephina makes a six-sided die in her Sharanis class and rolled it 60 times to test if each side was equally likely to show up. The table summarizes the outcome of her 60 rolls. These data provide convincing evidence the die is unfair. Alright, so this is the observed rolls. She rolled 13 ones, 11 twos, and so forth. The expected rolls would be even. 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, and 10. Theoretically. Okay? And also, there's a mistake here. This should be 60. Alright, here we go. Number one. What are we trying to do? We are deciding if the die is fair. And our alpha, 0.05. Number two, our ho and our ha. You can do it in words, it's easier that way. The ho-ha, the ho die distribution hasn't changed. Die distribution has not changed. In other words, it's fair. And my ha is going to be die distribution has changed, so that would be not fair. Moving on, number three, random, question mark, it did not tell us. So we're going to assume. Caution. And then expected. Greater than or equal to 5. Yes. Look at the table. Number 4. We're going to do our chi-squared. So, first off, we have 13 minus 10 squared over 10. All these are going to be over 10. And then we have 11 minus 10 over 10. And 6 minus 10 over 10. Plus 12 minus 10. And again, if you want to just type these in your calculator, you know, you just want to put 2 squared. If you want to do it in your hand, put 4 over 10 each time. Yeah, you can do this. However is comfortable for you. Plus 10 minus 10 over 10. So, you know, that one's going to go bye-bye. That's 0. And then last, 8 minus 10 over 10. And if you crunch those numbers, you get 3.4 after you convert it to a decimal. So remember, you're going to get a fraction answer, just hit the math key, and then hit decimal, and convert it. Number 5. Okay, 3.4, we've got here. Our DF is going to be 6 minus 1, which is 5. So if we take our calculator, on. Second bars, number 8. 3.4, the 999 stays, and we put in 5 here. We get 0.6386. So p-value .6386. Last but not least is our statement. Since my p-value is, I'm sorry, 0.6386 is greater than alpha of 0.05, we fail to reject the hope. We do not have convincing evidence that die is unfair. I don't know what I just wrote there. The dis? Yeah, not the dis, the die. That looks like an unfair. Okay, can you please just give me the eraser? There we go. Unfair. That's it. There's your homework. 2 problems. 634, 11, and 12.